All right, and he's going to speak about viruses again. Very popular today.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am greatly honored to be invited to the conference. In this paper, I would like to talk about the concept revealing strong correlation between computer and biological viruses. So the aim of the undertaken investigation is to execute a comparative analysis and find similarities between computer and biological viruses. Our hypothesis is that knowledge of specifics of computer and biological viruses will help specialists to lay a constructive platform for development of sophisticated methods of solving computer security problems. At the beginning of my presentation, I would like to define the term computer virus, which was coined by Fred Cohen in the early 80s. Such a name for a malware code was chosen due to the fact that, like its biological counterparts, a computer virus is essentially a sequence of information that codes its behavior in a host system. The term has remained unchanged up to the present moment, and it is still consistent with the main principles of the malware program. And the similarity between the two types of viruses is evident. To prove the hypothesis, it's important to mention that biological viruses use a blood system to transport themselves from one cell to another. And if we think of the internet as a blood system, we'll find that every computer connected to the net will represent a single cell. So a computer virus corrupts a cell, injuring it, and goes to another using the blood system, just as real biological viruses. But there is some difference. Taking a closer look on the problem, we find out that computer virus doesn't corrupt the whole computer. It corrupts only files or programs, or uses some operation memory. And biological viruses corrupt the smallest parts of the organism, cells, which they use to habitation and reproduction. But let's look at the virus infection closer. Reasoning along this line of thought, the denial of service attack can be compared to HIV. Human immunodeficiency virus, because both of them are aimed on the overloading a system. There are other similar features between computer viruses and HIV. HIV attacks the immune system, making humans more vulnerable to certain diseases. Computer viruses such as Win32 Sality use the same strategy, terminating antivirus programs and setting a malicious program as an authorized application to bypass Microsoft's firewall. Biological viruses such as influenza virus are also known to change upon replication. When viruses replicate, then mutate themselves. This behavior is comparable to the way the configure and cook phase viruses work. It's a real nightmare for security analysts because every replicated sample is significantly different from the predecessor. This can render antivirus signatures designed to detect malicious programs close to even useless. Another point I'd like to highlight is herd immunity. It's a concept from biological infection that also applies to computers. A disease relies on a certain critical mass to spread, and if your population is dominated by those who is immune to the infection, it helps to curtail the communication of the disease. To talk about immunity, looking at computers, we can see the example that, for example, computers with the Android operation system are resistant to Windows viruses. So I would like to emphasize one detail. Nowadays, one of the most dangerous types of crime is terrorism. And there is cyber terrorism. Hackers create and organize massive attacks that deal a lot of damage to internet or to different big companies. So we should wait to for new dangerous man-created biological viruses, because if we won't be ready to fight with them, humanity shall be in great danger. Now it's time to talk about the most obvious differences. For example, the way of creating of computer and biological viruses. It's worth noting how computer malware comes into being. Unlike biological viruses such as H1N1, malware doesn't spontaneously create new offspring. New viruses require the effort of black hat hackers who try to create code that is easy to replicate, hard to remove, and does something to benefit of its creator. For example, every day there appear about 5,000 of new computer viruses, and new biological virus appears once in 15 or 20 years. But the biggest difference seems to be in the fact that computer viruses are more complex and contain more code that dictates their behavior, thus allowing their creators more space to implement different tricks such as packing, encryption, virtual machine detection, or anti-debugging tricks. And just imagine what would happen if biological viruses had the same techniques and their disposal to thwart those who want to study and analyze them, never mind those who are infected with them. I've made an attempt to... there you can see some social work made by other student. He asked students about what they think of different features of viruses. At first, he questioned about location of viruses, what students think about it. Mostly, students answered that biological viruses locate out of host cells, and the biggest part of students think that computer viruses locate in the internet. The next question was about symptoms of infection. The biggest part of students think that the most obvious symptom of biological virus is high temperature, and for computers the most popular symptom is decreasing of operation memory. The next question was about the danger level of biological and computer viruses. Mostly students think that the general problem of computer and biological viruses is that they are really easy to spread. So that's all this social work.
Can you do it a bit faster?
Speed up.
So there you can see a table that collected all of the similarities or differences that I found during this work. So there are similarities, potential similarities, and differences. This table was made by Gerhard Kortov in 2006, and I've attempted to update it a bit because it was updated 3 years ago and it was quite old. that brings me to the end of my talk. Before I close, I want to emphasize the importance of the correlation of the two types of virology. There are more similarities than differences between them, and it's really logical to use some advances from computer virology in solving biological virology problems. And more detailed research of computer viruses can have positive impact on the evolution of biological virology. According to the theory, scientists should remember that biological virology can affect the perfecting computer security. But I think that we should be wondering of that fast evolution of computer viruses. If it is the same as biological viruses, we should wait some epidemics, and no one can predict how it will affect on humanity. Thank you for your attention, and feel free to ask any questions.
It's really impressive. Well, I think they are applauding you before you finish, before you answer the questions. All right, questions, please.
What do you think? What viruses is more dangerous now?
So there are different type of viruses, and I think that one type of virus can deal a lot more damage to one person. For example, if you have got a lot of information that is really important for you, so if you lost it, you are really harmed now. And other people have a lot of useful programs on his computer, no, their computer. And if a malicious program deleted, they acquire some harm too. So I think it's really specific for everyone.
No, I mean computer viruses or biological
viruses. For sure, I think that biological viruses are more dangerous because they can be lethal, at least.
Yes.
More questions?
Yes. What do you think is more expensive now, protection from computer viruses or biological viruses?
I think that that our governments waste more money on fighting with biological viruses because it's biological viruses can affect on humans, and I think that it's more important to save human lives than to save some information in the, on the computers and.
Thank you. Something else? Nothing. Okay, well, we are really very impressed. Thank you very much.